Response officers Dan and Alex are blue lighting to help some police community support officers on a job. They're worried that a man's flat has been taken over by some unwelcome guests.
We're 5 minutes out.
PCSOs, they've seen some people on a balcony who they know the occupants are for. They've contacted the occupants and they're saying that there should be no one in the address.
Before joining the police, I worked within mental health services, and we'd work sort of on a daily basis with police officers, bringing people who were in need of mental health care. And my interest in the police started from then, really. And I think the two roles are quite similar in the terms of wanting to help people and support people in their time of need.
In recent years, the Medway towns of Gillingham and Chatham have been targeted by County Line's drug gangs. The rightful tenant is known to be vulnerable, and police are worried that he's being exploited.
Yeah, so it's previous intel for this address linking to Cuckooing. Someone will take over, County Lines potentially will take over an address of someone who's quite vulnerable, and they will utilise that address to do their drug dealing from.
The victim has been afraid to come back to his flat while the men are inside.
Has he definitely confirmed, though, that he hasn't let these people in? As far as he's aware.
I rang him up, he said, do what you need to do, just get them out. If there's people in there, they shouldn't be in there.
Right.
As the men are known to carry weapons, firearms officers are on their way. But Dan and Alex are going in first.
Top floor.
When you go into these sort of jobs, you have adrenaline. You just cannot go to that incident without having that little sense of fear, but I think adrenaline takes over.
I can hear someone inside, and they're saying they haven't left, and they've been throwing stuff out the windows.
Police, open the door. We know you're in there.
How would they have got in?
Previously, they've kicked in.
Well, you can see marks here, yeah.
That's right. All right, well, we've got some officers that are outside the project right now.
Where we're forcing entry, we don't know who's going to be behind that door. And the minute you go through that front door, there's a risk that an axe or a hammer or other weapon is going to be used against you.
Police, open the door, we're going to put it in.
One kick.
Right. Yeah? Like, yeah, I'll give you a call back.
One kick. Right. Yeah, and then I'll have a taser in, mate.
Definitely people in there, yeah?
Yeah, that's what the housing office has confirmed, so.
Hello, police, stay where you are. Keep your hands where they are.
There are two men in the flat without the tenant's permission.
Yeah, sit on the sofa now. Take a seat.
So
we've had information to say you don't, all right? All right, is it just you two in?
Yes.
We've had information to say that you shouldn't be in here. Pop your hands out a minute.
Mate, I live here. You can ring and ask him.
Pass me your hands. At the moment, you're being detained.
We've had please.
Would you just be quiet a minute? We've had information to say you shouldn't be in here. We've knocked the door numerous times. What? If you, Ants, listen to me. I'm talking. If you're living here, why are you not answering the front door? What, to the police? Do you not see how silly your story sounds? I've asked you to open the door numerous times and you've not opened it. Now you're saying you live here. Yes, I did.
I knew his face as I've dealt with him previously.
What's your name? I recognise you. What's your name?
And they didn't want us there, but we had a job to do, and ultimately the victims called us to say they shouldn't be there. And there was drugs paraphernalia present, there was needles which had been used, empty drug spoons, which is what they used to place their drugs on, and the flat was quite untidy, which again is common for an address which is being cuckooed.
These are the items that were... Well, this one was near the patio door, and I think this one was near the living room door as you go in, and this one was located above the door, which again is not something normally placed above a doorway for a living room. There was intel to say that these items were potentially present in the address, particularly an axe.
The officers suspect that the intruders have taken over the property to use as a base from which to sell drugs.
Yeah, I think with Cuckooing, it's very rare that you're going to force entry or go into an address and find the person that's in charge of the county line or the top dog, if you like. A lot of the time it's the low-level drug dealers who are normally drug users themselves and often will come into debt to the people running the county lines because they will use the drugs that they're meant to be selling, which then becomes a debt to the drug dealers, and that's why it becomes a never-ending cycle.
No drugs have been found in the flat. But as the two men have accessed the property without the tenant's consent, they can still be arrested.
Both of you are going to be under arrest on suspicion of burglary, all right? I've just done it.
Partly... I've been living here a week. My clothes are on the fucking floor.
And the information I have at the minute is that no one should be in this flat at all. So at the minute, I say you're under arrest for that offence. You need to be interviewed. If you're living here, then you can provide proof that you're living here. Where's your T-shirt and your shoes, mate?
With the rest of my fucking belongings in there, I told you.
All right.
Fucking prick. Did you fucking leave, mate?
There's numerous clothes in here, mate. Which ones do you want?
Yeah, exactly. Numerous clothes. All my fucking belongings!
Well, I don't know that, do I? What do you want? Or is you can go down like that?
Well, I fucking said to you repeatedly, haven't I? My clothes are on the floor on the left.
Why are you getting so angry for?
Because you're fucking not listening, are you?
Well, I did. It's numerous...
You don't listen!
The bedroom's full of clothes. Yeah. What make of your trainers? What make of your trainers?
Absolute plants, mate. You sound like a trained robot. Burgling the place, and I've got all my possessions here. Yeah! Good police work, Medway! Thumbs up! Good work!
The owner of the flat obviously wanted to come back, but his mails were in his address, so the key was to get them arrested, to get them out to the van for transport to custody quickly so we could secure the flat and ensure that the victim had some form of security.
Hey, don't be stupid, mate. Hey, don't be stupid.
Get off. I don't mind him holding me.
Yeah, well, I want to make sure you don't fall down the stairs, mate.
The suspected predator is not about to leave the vulnerable man's flat quietly.
I'm not going down them stairs without my laces done up.
You are, mate.
I ain't, mate. Not without my laces done up. Mate, health and safety, mate.
Don't be stupid, mate. Listen, if anyone's going to fall now, it's because of the way you're behaving, which is all on camera, so I suggest you just walk. Just being stupid, mate.
You can do this an easy way, mate, or a hard way. Come on, we're working on a level. I don't want to be...
Dude, my laces up then. Health and safety.
Right.
You should know that.
Just walk.
Why can't you tuck them in? You put your shoes on. Can you not tuck them in?
I've got handcuffs on.
But you managed to put your shoes on with the handcuffs on.
Yeah.
So can you not tuck your laces in with the handcuffs on? You can do
didn't
it.
Didn't give me that chance, did you?
Well, try just do it now, then.
Can't bother. Don't want to have done that.
I knew straight away the reason why he wanted me to do that was because... It was a show of dominance that I'm bending down, tying his shoelaces up, which I wasn't happy to do. He was more than capable of putting his shoes on.
All right, stand up, walk downstairs.
Or what?
Sorry?
Or what?
Or we'll have to carry you downstairs.
One carry everyone.
All right.
The longer you sit here, it's now 4:20. It's been nearly an hour since I arrested you. The quicker you get into custody, the quicker you get interviewed. You could still get interviewed today. But the longer you sit here and wait, it's going to delay it.
On that day, his behaviour actually took up 4 officers. And obviously, you're taking vital resources and tactical operations off the road, such as firearms officers who were present, who, you know, are there to deal with incidents that may happen, such as life and death situations. And they're then dealing with this male because he's decided to play up.
We're still giving you the opportunity. You can still sit up, tuck your laces in, you can walk yourself down. Walk with me, yeah?
Hey, get him away from me.
Well, right? Just go with my colleague there. I said that earlier.
Let's go.
Mr. P. They call me fucking demon, bro. Don't know why. Had a bad side to me. I'm a good boy now, though. I'm a Roman Catholic. I'm laying there half naked and burgling the plates.
All right, you want to come up with me?
But his friend's behaviour has taken a turn for the worse.
Mate, don't do it here.
Hold on, Jamie, keep it on, mate. Keep it on.
Mate, there's females about, mate.
I don't give a shit.
Yeah, well, you should, shouldn't you?
No, I shouldn't.
It's disgusting, isn't it?
You shouldn't even be here, should I?
There's females there. You think that's nice?
I don't give a shit.
What do you think they want to watch you?
You just want to look at my anus?
Yeah, for your safety. Leave your arms down, mate.
No, fuck off.
Be stupid.
Fuck off.
Following on from the arrests, with that incident, unfortunately, there was not enough evidence to support a prosecution for a burglary. But I think the main thing in that incident was the safeguarding for the victim. But I'm hoping that through our intervention, the cuckooing may have been prevented and the victim could get on with his life and have his address back without any concerns of anyone turning up trying to sell drugs from his property.